For high temperature measurement, we recommend thermocouples.
Hi, I'm Dietmar. I'm senior application engineer for temperature measurement at Endress+Hauser. I'm working in the business for some decades and I want to share my expertise with you.
High temperature means above 600 degrees Celsius. They are quite easy. You see here in this antique measurement instrument, there's no battery, there's nothing. Just the thermocouple, so we will see two welded metals, and if I heat up, you see the analog instrument is rising up and we see high temperatures in it. If I do this long enough, we will see the red glowing thermocouples. And don't do this at home or in the office. I can do this, please do not. So, thermocouples, how do they work? You just connect two different metals together. That's more or less the tricky thing. Two metals or two alloys. Because of the changes in heat conductivity and heat of the possibility electrons can move through the inner structure of a metal, there is a small voltage produced related to the temperature. This is a thermoelectric effect, also known as Seebeck effect. Who discovered this? So it's really easy to make. You just weld two metals together. This is a hot junction. And on the other side, on the cold junction, you measure the millivolts or microvolts which are produced. So very robust design, but you see it is not a temperature measurement directly, it's a differential temperature measurement because the hot junction and the cold junction and what you measure is the difference between both of them. And so to measure the real temperature, we need to know the temperature of the cold junction, we need to know the characteristic curve of the material, and then we can calculate what is the temperature at the hot junction. This is a general principle of a thermocouple measurement. The thermocouple voltage is quite small, microvolts or millivolts, and this needs quite accurate electronic in the temperature transmitter. There are several already standardized thermocouple pairs, so two different alloys or metals. Let's focus on a few. The most popular one is called type K, which is nickel chrome nickel. And you see here at 1000 degree of temperature difference, we will have a signal of 45 millivolt. And yeah, this looks quite linear. For higher temperatures, chrome nickel is not suitable any longer. You have to go to noble thermocouples, which is typically platinum, platinum together with rhodium. The most popular here is type S. Type S is platinum on the one side and platinum and rhodium on the other side. And at, for example, at 1500 degrees Celsius of difference, we have only 15 millivolt of signal. And you can see here, this is a clear curve. It's not linear. So there is a quite complicated behavior in between, especially if you go to negative temperatures, you clearly see that there are curvy behavior of the thermocouples. So you, obviously platinum is quite expensive, so you only take this if type K is not longer suitable, especially at higher temperatures.
Hope you like it. If yes, watch out for the next video of this series and leave us a comment, a like, or share.